got it.
No.
Do not fuck with us!
Say it.
Because...
Say it.
Because we're the same person.
That's right.
We are the all singing, all dancing crap. I don't understand this.
You were looking for a way to change your life. You could not do this on your own. All the ways you wish you could be, that's me. I look like you want to look. I fuck like you want to fuck. I am smart, capable, and most importantly, I'm free in all the ways that you are not.
Okay, I don't want to go into the whole film of Fight Club because there's many elements of the film. So I'm just going to stick on that small part, right? When he realizes that he is Tyler Durden in the movie. And what Tyler Durden says to him is really, really important, dude. Really, really, really important. Because when he says that he is free in all the ways that he is not. Now, what does that mean? He's indifferent, right? He's indifferent. He doesn't care about what Jack cares about. He's completely free of all that nonsense of what other people think, all that stuff. And that's more important. That is the biggest asset that anyone can ever have walking around on two legs while you're alive. Okay? Now I have to wrestle with this. Like I said, I'm on a very small level, but I do know that I'm on a level that most people are not even started on. Because I can remember my older self and go, what the fuck was I doing, dude? Why did I have these emotions? Why was I getting triggered by this? Why was I getting involved? You know what I mean? That's a big one. Why was I getting involved in all these things? Why was I getting caught up with emotions? Why was I trying to solve problems that I was creating? Right? So when Tyler Durden says, I look like you want to look, I fuck like you want to fuck, and most importantly, I'm free in all the ways that you're not. And he's capable. That's what he says as well. He's capable, right? So he created that out of his false self did not want to live that false self anymore. But obviously it went to extremes. It went to extremes. But when you touch a tiny bit of freedom and you kind of look around and you think, wait a second here. Wait a second. There is consequences for whatever we do, all right? One of the things that really kind of helped me was this, right? Was that for an awful long time, I sat with myself. And in that sitting with myself, I got kind of like desensitized to anything happening, all right? So now that seems to be kind of like, I don't need really anything to be happening. It doesn't make any difference to me. Whether this is happening, that is happening, whether I'm going anywhere, whether anyone accepts me, where anyone likes me, there's still twinges there and stuff like that, right? But it still does not really, really matter. It does not matter. So there's a freedom in that. There's a freedom of indifference. If you can be indifferent to things that you took seriously before because of the program, it's not only like who causes all this? Well, the whole system is set up that way. It's a matrix, right? So it's all set up in a way for you to get you involved in everything. Like I was watching this thing on TV the other day, and it was like a news broadcast thing on the TV, and there was a little segment to the right of it, and it just had a picture of Donald Trump. And it just said, Trump thinks that he's going to be arrested on Tuesday, or he says that he's going to be arrested on Tuesday. Something like that, right?
Yeah, I'm concerned, dude. Yeah, let's do something about it. Yeah, let's all be concerned. We're solving problems here.
Setting up these matrices for people. This code here, that code there. Oh, you're involved in that. Trump is this. You're a Trump man. You're a this man. You're a that man. You have this label. You have this. You follow this breadcrumbs down here. You follow that breadcrumbs down there. You get involved in this down here. And then you take a step back and you think like, you know what? I don't really give a flying fuck what's going on in this world because it's killing me. I don't care. There's a part of me that really is indifferent and does not give a fuck. Then the paradox comes in. Then you can start, something can kind of warm you in the inside. And it can go, well, even though I don't really give a fuck, I look around at all these faces and I wish them well. If that makes any sense. I want the best for them. If I can help it, I don't want to add to their misery. I don't want to add to anything that's going on within them, which they keep secret and they don't tell anyone about. And I don't want to be a part of anything negative, if possible. If possible, right? Because I still waver and it still goes the odd way sometimes. But Tyler Durden was indifferent. He had an indifference to him. And in that, he had freedom within himself. He had freedom to express this way and to look at the world and alter where the situation need be. You see, we all try and look at ourselves as like a very hardened identity, right? I'm just thinking of one human being in my head right now who that was really poignant with. They have a hardened identity. This is who I am. This is who I am. And I can't deviate from it. And if anyone says anything to me or suggests anything to me, otherwise, we're going to have fucking problems. You see, we're supposed to be in flux. What is the word that Paul Enslaved uses? He says fluid and dynamic. That means that the I am presence, the source, the I am presence, a foundation, like a root system. Okay? And then however you act, react, or whatever in the outside world, it is like a stage. But you know you're acting in it, though. You know you're moving this way. You know you're moving that way. But when you sit on your own in the dark, you can be free in all the ways that everyone else isn't. Because they think that the freedom comes from going on the next holiday. They think freedom comes from attracting an attractive mate and having them as comfort. When really people don't want that. They want it on one level, but when they get it, then they find out, like, unless that being is very, very kind of like free in a way and is trying to connect on with the higher power, then that can be very, very different, because then you can learn from a being like that. You can learn from them and they'll hold that as the most important thing in their life, because without that, you're just stumbling around. You're just two people or three people stumbling around all over the place. And you don't know where you're going. It's like the blind leading the blind. That's what that phraseology comes from. So Fight Club was an interesting film. I remember watching that film years ago. 1999, it came out in the cinema. I thought it was really, really good. Like I said, there's a lot of things in the film that I wouldn't, that are kind of like subliminal programming I would look back at now. But that's not to say that little clips of the film, there wasn't bits of truth been talked about in it. See, I know no one will really believe this. They will listen to this and they won't really believe it. Right? When Paul says the words, you're a slave, right? Okay? He says, you're a fucking slave. You're a slave. Now, what they've managed to do, and my hat's off to them as well for how they've done it, man. I mean, like, wow, dude. That's why you should never trust anything to do with the government. Anything to do with that, because they want to keep humanity suppressed so they can keep running to the bank, right? They have turned us into slaves. That's what they've done. Heart and mind control, okay? They do it through sexual control as well, okay? They do it through a myriad of different things. The needle thing is a big one. You think that that is just like, you know, that they can enter in that way, okay? The TV, the radio, subliminal advertising, programming, they know that human beings are not connected to the source. It's the cruelest thing ever. Not connected to the source, so they're open to suggestion from so-called authority. So you have all these police walking around with Halloween costumes on. Okay, the judges with these costumes on. And these people that seem like they're in charge. Why do you think Christ was executed, if you believe the story? Why do you think there was nails hammered through that guy's feet and his hands, his wrists or whatever, and hung up on a cross, if you believe the story? I personally think that's more likely an analogy of the sun. But just say, even if you believe the story. Because it is man's story as well, whether it happened or not. Why do you think it happened? Because he's going to interfere with it. They can get us into the trap. They can take us a long time to get into the trap, right? You can have certain people that can kind of like get you out pretty quick as well, if you're open to it. So people like that, they're the biggest danger. You know, someone who's a robber or a serial killer or a murderer, they don't give a shit about that. They actually encourage it. They love it because it gives the idea that the police are out there protecting us. They love all that. How many of these people are setups for a start as well? As well, I'm not saying all, because that would be impossible. But some of them are kind of like, I'd say they're set up to try and scare the general public through the news media. Okay, so it gives them, like, legitimate, we need to have the FBI, we need to have a big, massive police force, we need to have this, that, and the other, because there's dangers out there. So we keep giving our power away to everyone all the time. Safety, 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 safety. And then we never stop to think, there is no safety. There is no safety, and not only is there no safety, we don't need any. Why the fuck do we need safety for, dude? We need to use our wits. But Fight Club, that part in Fight Club is really, really interesting, because when he says that, I'm free in all the ways that you're not. You think about that for a second. They have put us into slavery, like I said, segue back to the Paul thing. When he talked about that, it's on so many levels they've done it. Heart and mind control. They're robbing our income through income tax. They're robbing everything through the banking system. They're getting us to submit everywhere so we're reliant on them in some ways. They're just doing what they want, and they're above the law, right? They create the law, right? Why do you think they call it the criminal justice system? Because there's criminals running the justice system. That's why they call it the criminal justice system. Okay? These are the apex predators, and they've done it in a very kind of like, you know, it's the only way they could do it. Because there's too many people. If too many people found out that we're slaves, right? That we're suppressed, that we're don't dare express anything because your friends might say something to you. The people that you rely on might say something to you. You can't do this, you can't do that. Even if you're naturally supposed to be doing something, right? So to be free, you have to be indifferent. You have to develop indifference where it doesn't really give a fuck. And the way you can do that is you can train yourself to embarrass yourself sometimes on purpose when you don't want to do it. You can train yourself by being rejected as much as possible. You can train yourself in doing loads of different things and ask people questions where they have to say no. They have to say no. You can walk up to someone and say, look, could you do this for me and can you do that for me? And they'll say, no. You do it yourself. I'm not doing it. Oh, okay. Right? And then you get used to rejection. You get used to all them kind of things. So freedom does not come from being right all the time and being, you know, it can come from being the class clown in loads of ways too. Okay? So there's many different ways to do it. We are slaves. The majority of us are slaves. We're slaves to compulsion. We're slaves to giving our wealth away. We can't get any property rights anymore because they own it through trickery. Given everything away, and we haven't even known we've given anything away, because it seems like an okay idea, right? But if you're dead inside and you're relying for the next holiday or the next lover to come along, you know, not that there's anything wrong with that. Everyone likes sex, dude. Everyone likes that. Everyone likes to be touched. It's necessary, okay? It's all very, very, very necessary. Everyone makes a big deal out of all that kind of stuff as well. No, it's necessary, but it's not really going to do anything for you. You have to be going towards a level to do with the creator and to do with reality and developing. That's why a lot of us are miserable and depressed, because we're not developing inwardly in any way whatsoever. And that basically the development inwardly means that you don't hate any. Hating people, right? You can't. How can you live with yourself when you're hating people all the time, dude? You can't. Your freedom has to come first. Your freedom comes first. You can't afford to be hating people and have a hate in your heart. It might come up a tiny bit every now and then, because someone does something and then you get angry and stuff like that a little bit, then it subsides again. But I mean, like, to hold it in your heart all the time because of what people have done. We can't be doing that because how can we be free that way? And they have power over us that way as well. Okay? People are demons. Okay? They're demonic. They're pieces of trash, filth, scum, slime, sludge. Still, you can't be hating them. You have to have a care in your heart for them at the same time as well. You can't be free any other way. It's not possible. Okay, that's why the Christed being said, forgive your enemies, love your enemies. And that doesn't mean that you have to, like, you know, oh, I like them and you know, and hug them all the time. I want to be around them. No, I don't want to fucking be anywhere around them, right? But it basically means that you have to take care of yourself. And if you're hating people that are doing things on you, react to them, of course, which need be, right? Do what you got to do. But if you're hating them in your heart, you can't be free. You can't be free. It's impossible. It's a paradox, right? But you can't be. You can't be. You've got to be indifferent. That's what Tyler Durden was talking about to Jack. And I'm free in all the ways that you're not. You can't be free if you're stuck in the Matrix. You can't be, because you're just going to be looking for something that can't be found that way. Can't be found that way. You know, so I'm not sure if I'm going to even print this. I didn't do any research on this one. I was going to. Maybe I should. I don't know. But sometimes I just like to speak off the cuff. And sometimes I can be way, way better. I yield.